Welcome to Veterans Forum, a program by veterans, about veterans, for veterans and their families. I'm your co-host, Bob West, with Ray Chattery and Jerry Devlin. Our goal is to provide important information on legislation, benefits, support, and activities for you and your family by interviewing leaders in our community. Jerry, who do we have with us today?
Tonight, we're very honored to have with us Geraldine Valentino Smith, who is a member of the Bowie City Council and a large councilwoman. And Geraldine is kind of unique in this area because she's really a native daughter. She went through the Bowie school system all the way. She's a graduate of Ogle, Bowie High School in the celebrated class of 1982. And then she went on to Catholic University in Washington, where she got her nursing degree and RN. And then went on and went to law school at Catholic University. So she's nurse and attorney. It's a kind of a remarkable background. And she comes from a family, her dad was a very old friend of mine, comes from a very remarkable family here in Bowie. And she's particularly sympathetic to the cause of veterans and would like to tell us about her views on things. That's why Geraldine is here.
Welcome, Geraldine.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. What an honor to be here. Three very good-looking men on an evening to talk about such
an
important to talk about such an important issue. And I think, as Judge Devlin said, you know, you bring your background with you wherever you go, and you bring your background with you when you make decisions. And my father graduated from Kings Point, was a merchant marine, and his brother, and he was in Korea. My niece is an active duty in Norfolk with the Navy. My husband's father was in the war, and his brother, my husband's father's brother, was lost in a prisoner of war camp. And he's the youngest of nine, his two older brothers served in Vietnam. So I certainly bring with me the background and the sensitivity to these very important issues that you discuss and the information you bring. And I hope, you know, going forward that, you know, you make decisions based on your background, and my background clearly is very sensitive to the needs and issues of veterans.
Well, we're certainly glad to have you here. And we know the city of Bowie has been helping veterans for a long time. And we're especially keen on the number of members that show up at our veterans functions and support veterans at every turn. And we're also well aware that you're running for office as a delegate, and what we'd like to do is inform you a little bit about some of the issues that are confronting veterans not only in Bowie but Prince George's County and throughout Maryland. And Jerry, you could probably fill us in a little bit on some of the issues that are coming up.
Well, there's a number of issues that we're facing. One, of course, is a bill that's pretty much in every year. It's the bill to provide subtraction modification in the state income tax for retired military, which you two guys would probably like. The other bill that I think has priority is our bill to allow our local veterans posts to have slot machines. Our membership, of course, is growing old, and we have charitable responsibilities, and it's hard to meet all the needs. Presently, the veterans posts in 8 of the 9 counties on the Eastern Shore are allowed to have slot machines, and there is a local bill which has passed the House already for Worcester County to be the 9th, but we are interested in the statewide, and this is kind of, as we say, kind of an us and them bill. If you're really a friend of veterans, this is the time to show it. I mentioned that to the House Ways and Means Committee. Everybody pays lip service to veterans, and we're pretty popular if you're running for office. But occasionally you get a chance to add deeds to words, and this is one of those bills that does. And I might point out, too, with Geraldine's sensitivity on veterans issues, that I was in the General Assembly from this district for 12 years. When I came to the legislature, it was very typical. We had Ed Conroy was the senator, and Leo Green and Dave Ross were the other two delegates. I was, of course, a Marine, and they were soldiers. And almost everybody in the legislature who was male, and some of the women, were veterans. So you didn't have to always explain things. So that's why it's important to have people who are sensitive. A couple of years ago, we had Delegate Mary Delaney James from Harford County down as the keynote speaker at the Marine Corps League convention. And Mary Delaney sponsored the bill for criminal penalties for those idiots who were here in Bowie a couple of weeks ago who break up military funerals. But her great uncle was the commander of the 2nd Marine Division at Taro, and almost all the male members of her family were Marines. And while she's not a veteran, she has a special kind of sensitivity. And I think Geraldine does, too. And, you know, I think it speaks well for her.
Well, and one of the important things, too, Geraldine, is women veterans and the special needs that women have. And I'm sure it's not unlike some other women's issues that are important to women locally in general. Family, young children, health issues, and so forth. You might be able to tell us a little bit about what's happening maybe in Bowie as it pertains to women's issues that may carry over into women veterans.
Well, you know, right now at the municipal level, we don't have as much specificity with the budget priorities. But I think what we do have is a real sensitivity to making sure that we are honoring the veterans with the Memorial Day Parade and participating as much as we can with all of the veterans' events. And, you know, with respect to women across the board in the city, it's through the various programming that we have, so it's not always as directed towards the military, but it may be that we need to go back and look at whether we need to redefine some of those educational offerings that Youth and Family Services does to direct it towards those that may have military needs, because I don't know that we've done that yet, and I think I'm going to take that back as a suggestion now.
I think there's probably a lot of programs that are available to citizens within Bowie that also would be helpful to veterans. And we're also trying to do a survey at the county level, trying to find out who our veterans are and what their veterans' needs are, too, through the survey that the Prince George's County Commission for Veterans has developed.
Well, Mr. Chattery, Ray, has instilled upon me the fact that we have the largest number of veterans here in this county. And I think that that's something that you really need to keep a focus on, because you can lose sight of that until you're told you are the county holding the largest number of men and women that have preserved what we all take for granted. And I think focusing on their needs is what government needs to do. You have limited resources, but those resources need to be directed at the true needs.
Mm-hmm. Ray's a post commander at the DAV, and he can tell us a little bit more about the legislation and how important it is for a post commander.
Right. Well, as I say, as Geraldine said, we have almost 80,000 veterans in the county and 32,000 female veterans statewide. And just doing a little math, I would say 3,000 to 4,000 are right here in the county. And Council Member Diane Palagnon was our guest a few weeks ago, and she really covered a lot of the women's veterans issues. In the DAV, we try to get the ladies to come out to our meetings, and we just now have elected a lady to be our chaplain, and she's going to be active. And at the VFW post, we had a couple ladies show up, and they were very, very happy to be welcomed like they did. They said another post, they weren't as welcome as they were in Bowie. So we go all the way around. The DAV National is a really big push on legislation for veterans, especially at the national level. And we just like it to trickle on down.
Even in the, for example, in the Marine Corps League, we had the national level, the national commandant, two women in a row.
Right.
And it's, we had also an interesting thing here in the DAV in Bowie. A group of us were sitting around the bar one night drinking, mostly Marines, but not all. And the only person who had been in combat was Mary Devine, who then was a chaplain for
right.
the DAV.
Right.
You just, you know, you look at, you know, the evolution. I mean, obviously women were not always included in the military. It's been an evolution. And I think that for each section of the military, it's experienced its own form of that evolution. But what I was really marked by when I watched my niece, she graduated from Villanova ROTC, and I went up for many of the parades and marches and watched all the young men and women.